What's up, guys? Welcome back to All Wings Everything. I am your cook, Spinelli. I am the self-proclaimed wing king and the prince and ruler of all lemon pepper wings. Now, if you think you got the best lemon pepper wing recipe, then shame on you, because you don't. Click that link above me. I'm gonna show you how to make the best lemon pepper wings on the planet. Now, in today's video, I have another easy appetizer recipe. Now, this is gonna be in my 5-day series of Cinco de Mayo. Now, as you know, Cinco de Mayo is coming up, so I decided to make some easy Cinco de Mayo recipes, guys. So the first one I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you guys how to make baked fish tacos. This is a delicious recipe. If you haven't had fish tacos, you're missing out. Now, I know you won't be able to go out and go to restaurants and celebrate Cinco de Mayo. Well, probably in some states you may be able to do it, but here in Florida, you won't be able to do it. But that doesn't mean you can't enjoy right in your house. You can still eat good and you can still drink good. And I'm gonna show you how to do it. So I hope you're in your kitchen. I'm already in mine, so let's go. All right, so here are the ingredients we're going to use today. We have some panko seasoned breadcrumbs. We're gonna use some Cajun seasoning, some paprika, some sea salt, one egg, chili powder, garlic powder, cumin, black pepper, some coleslaw, and I have some cheddar jack cheese right here. And like I said, we got this coleslaw right here. And we have, I have about a pound of cod fillet. So the type of fish you wanna use, you wanna make sure you use like a thick fish. You can use tilapia if you want to, but I like a thick flaky fish for my fish tacos. And I have right here some corn tortillas. Now, you can use flour tortillas, but I like the corn tortillas. First of all, they're healthier than the flour tortillas, but I just like the taste of corn tortillas. So these are the ingredients we're gonna use. So let's get started. All right, guys, I'm gonna give you a pro tip of how you can get your soft shell tortilla to like that. If you wanted to send them like your regular tacos, what you want to do is, what I do is I have my oven preheated to 365 degrees. I'm sorry, 375 degrees. And what you want to do is you just want to place this onto your rack like that. And so I'm going to place several of them like this onto my rack like this. And what you're going to do, once you get them all placed in here, so you're gonna slide it in there easily so they don't fall, and you let them cook for about 15 minutes, just like this. All right, 15 minutes, we'll come back. All right, so while we have our tortillas in the oven, what we're gonna do is we're gonna prepare our fish. So what you wanna do is you just wanna cut cut them in chunks. So I'm gonna start with like an inch. All right, and then I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna cut it this way into these chunks, just like this. All right, so I'm gonna do the rest of it this way. These already look like they got little grooves in them, so I just use those grooves that are already in there. Like, see, if you see these little grooves there, I'm just cutting them in those grooves. Makes it easier. So you get three nice little chunks. Again, guys, you don't have to use cod, but you can use tilapia. But when I do fish tacos, I like a thick, flaky fish. Like, to be honest, I don't like fried cod. You know, I don't fry my cod if I have it. I'm either bake it or grill it. And that's it. It's just that easy. That's what we have. All right, let's go check on our tortillas. All right, let's check on our tortillas. See, I look at what we got, guys. This is what I'm talking about. And see, look at that. See, it's how puffy you put your tacos in there. Yeah, this is gonna be good. Now, I don't want mine too crispy. And so I'm gonna take them out. Now, I still like them to be a little soft. Look at that, still soft. So let me find a pan to put them on. This is what you have. So that's a pro tip for if you want your tacos to stand up like regular tacos, you could do it in the oven like this. All right, so let's get back to making this fish. So all right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm just going to season this with a little salt. Not much, but just a little salt. You know how I like to have salt also, even though it's gonna be in the breading, I like the salt to be also on my actual meat or fish, whatever you want to call it. This will give it a little bit, just some added flavor. All right, and let's move on. All right, so now we're getting a little bit closer to getting these things, these fish pieces in the oven, battered and in the oven. So what we have here, I have 2 teaspoons of Cajun seasoning, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of pepper, 1 teaspoon of smoked paprika, 1 teaspoon of cumin, 1 teaspoon of garlic powder, and 1 egg whisk. Now, I have 1 cup of panko breadcrumbs here, and what I did with them was I put them in the oven for 5 to 7 minutes to get them toasted on 375. So you want to do that before you actually dip your fish in there. So put them in the oven, toast them for about 5 to 7 minutes, and you should have a nice little golden brown like this. All right, so let's move on. All right, so what we're going to do is we're just going to dump all our seasoning into this mixture, to your breadcrumbs, your Cajun seasoning, chili powder, salt, pepper, cumin, smoked paprika, and garlic powder. All right, so what we're gonna do now is just whisk that all together. So you're gonna have this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful coating. That's my timer going off on my stove. Right. Take a look at that. All right, that's what we have. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with our battering, dipping our fish and getting it coated to get it on the pan, all right? So bring our fish back into the mix, and we're gonna grab our pan. I've already lined it with aluminum foil. And let's get this thing sprayed with a little cooking spray, all right? So the way this works is we're gonna dip our chicken in, I'm so used to cooking wings, gonna dip our fish into the egg mixture, egg wash, get it coated, the breadcrumbs, and we're gonna sit it right there. Let's do another one. See what that looks like? See that, guys? All right, we'll stick that right here. And if you know, if you've been watching this channel a lot, you know what I say about doing this dipping and then coating. It's real tedious, it takes a lot of time. Some people don't have the patience to do it. However, I do, because I know what the final results are gonna be, and that's a delicious meal. You have to sometimes be patient when you're cooking. That's if you wanna get your, if you want a good result, you have to be patient, right? So, I know you guys don't wanna sit and see me do this in real time, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna speed this up for you, so I can go ahead and get it over with. All right, guys, so it looks like we're down to the final pieces. And my pan is pretty much overcrowded. Let me see if I can move a couple of these pieces down to make room for this last one. All right, so take a look at this, and this is how it's gonna look. Doesn't that look good? Look at that. See how it's breaded? Looks very good. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna place them in the oven for about 12 to 15 minutes and until it's golden brown. All right, so let's go ahead and add these to the oven. All right, so as we wait until the fish is finished, this is what we're gonna use to prepare our fish tacos. Coleslaw, we have the cheese. I'm using, I'm gonna have some lime in there, guys. Tomatoes and some red onions. Now, there's a secret, guys. I don't know if you know, but these onions are not red, they're purple. I don't know why they call them red onions. If anybody knows why they call them red onions, let me know. However, okay, so this is what I'm using to prepare it. Guys, you don't have to use this. You can make your taco any way you please, but this is what I'm gonna use. And seems like those fish are almost done, so I'll see you in a bit. All right, guys, so now our fish pieces are done. Take a look at them. Now, I did try one of them out. That's why one is missing right there. So let me see how hot they are. See if we can pick one of these up and let you take a look at it. Look at that. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna transfer these into a dish, and then we're gonna start. Because what you wanna make sure, you wanna make sure you can tie flakes with the fork like that. That's how soft it needs to be. So we're gonna transfer these over into a dish, and then we're gonna get them all flaked up so we can start preparing our tacos. All right, so I'm just putting these over in a bowl. And I'm just gonna start flaking them up like this. It's not that just fork it. It's just that easy. See that? Let's flake it up like that. And that's what we have. Let's take a look at that. And let's get these things made. I'm ready. And this is what we have, guys. So take a look at this after they've been plated up. Take a look at that now. That looks so delicious, so delicious. All right, so let's go ahead and finish off this recipe and give you guys a closer look. And there you have it, guys. Cajun fish tacos. This is a delicious and easy appetizer that you guys can try. It's filling. Let's get inside those tacos, take a look at them. So guys, I garnished it with a little cilantro. Like I said, I did put some slaw in it, some cheese, some red onions, some tomatoes. Now you can use your own, if you want to create your own taco sauce, you can. Typically with mine, I throw a little, you know, I could put a little hot sauce on it, or I will do something like just squirt some lime over the top of it, and that's sufficient enough for me. So guys, if you like this video, go ahead, hit that like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel and you like good wing recipes and you want to learn how to make easy appetizer recipes, go ahead, subscribe to the channel. You won't be disappointed. All right. Also, I've left the measurements and the ingredients in the video description below. So if you wanna go and pick up these items, you can click those links. It'll take you straight to Amazon for you to pick up those items. Also, this does help the channel when you buy from those links. And until then, your cook Spinelli, all wings, everything, and I am out. Peace.